I know. So let's go ahead and give her a warm welcome.
Okay, so I'm going to try and speak loud. My voice has been in and out, so just bear with me. But first, I'm going to share my story, my faith story, and then I'm going to share a message that I think God's really been putting on my heart. So to start off, my exposure to Christianity started at a really young age. I started kindergarten, going to private school, and I grew up going to church with my family. And although we went to church, it was definitely not a priority, and as I grew older, it became less and less important. When I was 3 years old, my parents got divorced. So they both had joint custody of me and my sister, so I went back and forth and lived at both homes. Growing up, I saw a lot of brokenness throughout my family. I saw and just dealt with a lot of things that were really difficult for a child to see at that age, just the home life and their circumstances living were just not good at all. Just like utilities being turned on and turned off, and finances were really difficult. But I continued to go to private school all the way through high school, and I'm so grateful for that because that gave me such a foundation in my faith. I was exposed to the gospel and I learned all about who Jesus was, but I did not know him personally. I did go through a lot of hardships, like I said, with my family, but I often felt alone. My parents didn't really have enough money to send me to private school, but they continued to, even though we couldn't afford it. And because of this, I just kind of had a sense of not belonging. I was one of few children from a divorced family at my school, and all the other kids in my school, their families were just well off financially. And I absolutely love my family, but sometimes I just felt different from others because of the family that I came from. I sometimes felt humiliated just from the situations I was in and not being able to afford to do a lot of the same things that my peers were doing. And I had this constant fear that I wasn't going to be able to play the sport that I loved anymore or continue at the school that I was at because we couldn't afford it. These experiences definitely resulted in my own insecurities of just not belonging, and I often just felt out of place because of those environments. I did value the friendships that I had really closely, and because of that, I got really hurt or disappointed when they didn't last. And going into high school, I was definitely known as just like the shy, like quiet soccer girl, and like that was my thing. I missed a ton of school because of soccer. So people just didn't really want to bother. I was respected, but I wasn't really paid much attention to. I wasn't really pursued at all. So this also gave me a lack of belonging. So I continued to put my identity in soccer. Like, that was my outlet for everything. And starting my senior year, I was also in a serious dating relationship that was not centered on Christ. And I thought things were going really well and that this is the direction that I should be going in. But I just remember all of a sudden I had a very clear and distinct void in my heart that I knew that there was something more. And winter of that same year in high school, I went on a retreat with my school, and that's where God really started to stir things up in my heart. So coming into college, I was more curious about my faith, but I didn't really think that this would be such a big part of my life anymore because I wasn't going to be around it as much. But eventually, the complete opposite happened. I first started out my freshman year here, just experimenting with a typical college life, going to parties, and just trying to figure out soccer and school and fit all that together. But I soon came to realize that it was just not fulfilling at all. And then early fall of my freshman year, one of my teammates invited me to come to Athletes in Action with her. And I just remember walking in and feeling so just welcome, and I was so drawn to how personable and accepting that the people were. So I decided to come back every week. And this is where I just kind of started feeling that more sense of belonging. And I ended up going to winter retreat and different things with AIA. So in my first year here, I was still definitely learning a lot and adjusting to things, but it wasn't really until my sophomore year when my one teammate started discipling me that I started to really understand the gospel. I realized that God has a plan for my life and that he loves me and that I am a sinner and I need Jesus. That he died on the cross for my sins, past, present, and future, and that he wanted to have a personal relationship with me. He wanted me to know him and to belong to his family. So after realizing this, I just remember being right here in Yunkin, sitting upstairs with my teammate, just in tears. I just was so overwhelmed by Christ's presence and his love. And that was just such a big defining moment in my faith, because right there was when I knew I wanted to follow Jesus. And definitely it was a process that took a lot of time and still taking time. But the more and more I pursue the Lord, the more he's captivated my heart. I definitely still struggled with knowing what it looked like to walk with the Lord daily. So I decided to go with Athletes in Action to Ultimate Training Camp, where you learn how to glorify God in your sport. And this is where I really fully surrendered everything to the Lord. Soccer had always been such a big part of my life, but once I understood what that looked like playing for God, I kind of understood why I was playing soccer and my purpose for playing it. Once I understood that, I completely surrendered to God at that camp. It changed the way I outwardly lived my life. Since soccer had been such a big part of my life, once I knew that my identity was in Christ, and what it looked like to play for him, soccer was no longer at the center of my life, Jesus was. And throughout my journey, God has definitely always been there, but one verse that has truly captured my longing to always belong and what I've always been searching for is in 1 Peter 2:9. "But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light." So I truly belong to Christ's family, and I am God's possession chosen. So that's my story. Now I'm going to kind of go into a message. I have some water. So now I'm just going to talk about how God showed me a lot through adversity, disappointment, and community. It's been such an honor to have been able to play soccer here for the past 4 years. And coming to a big school, it was definitely an adjustment. Because I kind of always felt like a little fish in a big pond, and I did have to face a lot of adversity through my sport. So the first point I'm going to talk about is just adversity and disappointment. And through soccer, I definitely dealt with a lot of adversity and disappointment, and coming in with high expectations, as I had worked my entire life in soccer to get to this point. And when we have high expectations, we become even more disappointed when these expectations do not measure up to reality. I worked so hard, but I often didn't really see the results, as I did not really get to play as much as I wanted. And this definitely led to major disappointment and often put me in a tough position, questioning whether Ohio State was the place for me to be or not. God definitely showed me so much throughout this disappointment, as it ultimately brought me closer to him. He showed me, in order to get through this trial, that I had to put him and others before my own personal desires. And he really spoke to me at the beginning of my senior season. At the end of one distinct game, I just had been having a lot of selfish thoughts about just my role on the team and everything. But it was right then when I decided to put all those aside and to put my team first by the way I was going to react. So the rest of the season, I definitely dealt with ups and downs as far as playing time and other things. But for the first time in 4 years, I had a different light and approach to things about it. And I knew what role I was in, and I decided to embrace it and let God use me in that position. So now, being done with soccer and seeing the bigger picture, I'm so grateful that God placed me in that position, because I've grown so much from it. And if I had the choice to go back and choose college all over again, knowing what I know would have happened with my career, I would choose Ohio State over and over again. And that's mostly because this is where I learned to grow in my faith. This is where I met Jesus, and that's so much more important than anything else. So I have a verse that kind of goes along with that, and it's up on the screen. Romans 5:1-5. "Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand. And we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. And hope does not put us to shame, but God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us." So here it's talking about how we're secure in our hope and salvation because we know and believe what God says. And where we stand in Christ is everything. And when we stand with Christ, everything has meaning. And because of this, we can embrace our sufferings and our tribulations. And we rejoice in those sufferings because we know that God's using life's difficulties to build our character. And the problems that we run into will develop our perseverance, strengthen our character, deepen our trust in God, and give us confidence about the future. We must thank God for these opportunities and grow and deal with them in His strength. So, in the second slide, I want to encourage you guys just to step out in your faith on your team and with your peers. I had my teammate Megan pour into me when she was here, and when she left, I definitely want to do the same with my teammates. But sometimes I kind of just felt like when I put this all on myself, I also often felt disappointed and just felt like I wasn't really making an impact or the impact that I wanted to. But God has shown me to persevere and not give up because He's the one who's at work in everything, not myself. I'm so thankful for all my teammates, and what has been most important for me is being able to pass on what God's shown me in my relationship with Him to them. I'm praying as I leave that some other girls will continue on and have a spiritual impact on the team. And I know that God has used me to plant seeds, and it's my heart's desire for these seeds to grow. And then also the verse I feel that really goes along with this is up here. 1 Corinthians 3:6, this is Paul speaking. I planted the seed, Apollos watered it, but God has been making it grow. So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who makes things grow. So Paul planted the seed of the good news message in people's hearts, and Apollos watered that seed to help believers grow stronger in their faith. But ultimately, God's the one who makes all of that grow. So do not be discouraged or disheartened when you do not see the fruit from the seeds that you planted. Our success is measured by our faithfulness to God. It is His work in and through you. And there are things that God's working on that we cannot see, but that does not mean that they're not happening. So the effect of that planting takes faith, and the effect of the watering is faith, but the decisive, the ultimate cause of that faith is the life and growth of the plant. It's not the life and growth of the plants, but it is alone God. So we may not be able to explain it, but we know that He knows, and we can find comfort in that through our faith and in His word. So next slide. So kind of my last topic I want to talk about is community. Because communities really help me be able to kind of persevere through those adversity and those disappointments. Having others walk beside me has enabled me to get through adversity. So God calls us into community and fellowship with other believers. We can experience God's presence and through relationships with other people. As community challenges us to be more like Jesus. And in Hebrews 10:24-25, let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works, and let us not neglect our meeting together, as some people do, but encourage one another, especially now that the day of His return is drawing near. So God's word tells us that we are put in relationships in order to encourage one another in pursuit of God and His kingdom. It's within the context of community that we are given the opportunity to be refined followers of Christ. So on the next slide, next point about community, it empowers our relationship with God. In Proverbs 27:17 says, as iron sharpens iron, so one person sharpens another. So when we are surrounded by other believers, we feel empowered in our faith. And there's something powerful about believers joining together and holding each other accountable. We need others to ask us the hard questions and to challenge us to live out our faith. So in the next slide, the last point about community I have is community through humility. In Philippians 2:1-4, therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from His love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and one of mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of others. So when we work together, caring for the problems of others as if they were our own problems, we demonstrate Christ's example of putting others first and experience that unity. And considering others' own interests as more important than our own links us to Christ, who was that true example of humility. So just a few closing thoughts that I had. Athletes in Action has enabled me to be surrounded and to surround other believers, which has made such a huge impact in my faith. Living in community with Christian roommates has encouraged me to pour into others as I'm being poured into by them. And I leave you with encouragement to seek out community. Who you live with, who you live life with really does make a difference in your walk and in your journey of faith. And do not be afraid of adversity, but embrace it when it comes your way and allow God to use it to help you grow and learn more about Him. So thank you guys so much for allowing me to speak.